Gee, I'm glad to see you guys this evening. I haven't played a show in 2 weeks. And that for me is a very, very long time. I have been busting to get up here. Tupelo Music Hall, Londonderry, New Hampshire. I get lost crossing the street. I can't find my own 2 feet. But I love my baby and she thinks I'm sweet. I must be doing something right.
Whether in London or Londonderry, Livingston Taylor seems completely at home with his audience, a relationship he's nurtured for some 40 years.
When we get in that mood, I must be doing something right.
I need them. They, all due respect to the wonderfulness of me, they don't need me.
Livingston's career got started at 17, the younger brother of a pop and folk superstar.
If you've never heard me before, I say, well, I'm James Taylor's brother, and, you know, I sound and look a little like James. And so if you don't like the way James looks or sounds, then the chances are you're not going to be that enthusiastic about me. But other than that, it'll be fine.
We're the best of friends. Are we wise? Thinning hair, fuzzy eyes, your face.
He is very close to his very musical family. They still gather for holidays and the like, but he insists they don't sing at family get-togethers, at least not usually.
But I missed my birthday, and I was supposed to go out to James's house in the Berkshires. And my sister Kate called me up, and my niece Sally, my nephew Ben, my sister Kate, James, all sang happy birthday to me over my answering machine, and I got to tell you, it was one of the best renditions of Happy Birthday that I had ever heard. Dang, my family can sing.
And they can write. Livingston's songs often built upon some pretty colorful characters, not necessarily autobiographical.
Letting the whiskey do my talking from my home. Every time I'm sober and open my mouth, everything turns out wrong. Oh, don't ask me nothing. Walk on and let me be. From now on, the whiskey talks for me. From now on. Whiskey talks for me.
That said, in fact, I don't drink. I don't drink alcohol or take mood-altering drugs, with a glaring exception of caffeine and white sugar. I'm not as herbal as I ought to be. It's a song. Hold on a second. Let me grab this guitar. So yeah, you know, it's I hate to admit it. I eat a lot of greasy food. And if you don't believe it, catch me in the nude, Beavis and Butthead on my TV, Ring Ding Slim Jim's Jujubes, slamming brewskis in my BVDs. I'm not as herbal as I ought to be. And the answer is that's true.
He shares a lot in his performances. Relaxed and wry, often striking a familiar chord.
I wasn't in my 20s, 30s, or 40s. I was in my 50s when I wrote the song. And the phrase I came across was, never lose hope, never lose hope. And I thought that'd be a lovely theme to write around. And so, with much enthusiasm, I grabbed a scrap piece of paper and a pencil, started in, not realizing how much hope I was going to need to rhyme the word hope through an entire song. You can do it till the dream comes true. You can do it till the sky goes blue. I know it's dark, but in your heart there's a light that will see you through. Here's a melody. to help you cope, even when you're at the itty-bitty end of your rope. Jump up, join in again, shoulders up, stick out your chin, elbow grease and soap. Oh, never lose hope.
If I didn't need to be around an urban area, I love the relief that going to New Hampshire affords me. My brain rinses out in New Hampshire. I feel sanity coming back into my life when I'm in New Hampshire. So it's really a joy to be there. That said, the fact is that I need cities. I need the pulse of a New York and a Boston and a Los Angeles, Chicago, San Francisco. I love a major city.
Indeed, we met up with him at the Berklee School of Music in Boston, where he's taught for 19 years.
Well, my name is Livingston Taylor, and I'm a professor here at the school.
Coming up, tips on the art of performing from a musical master.
You guys like it when he looks at you and smiles?